Guys, welcome to our first online video. We're doing this for the Samsung CCTV product lineup. We apologize for running a few minutes late. We just have an issue with the video setup, so we're actually going to shoot this from our cell phone live and hopefully switch through to the camera work later. Okay, to introduce what today is about. Today is about the Samsung CCTV system that we want to launch to our partners, which is the wholesalers only. We'll sign contracts with us. The system is a proven system. It's designed that you can do clear sight surveys, you can offer quotes to your clients that look professional, that are A3, that cover everything, you don't leave any components out, and it's easy to use. So if you're a salesperson on the road and you need to put a quote to your client, you can put the quote together literally within 15 minutes. It prevents all mistakes on sites because it follows a proven system on sight surveys, you complete the book and hand it in. In order to facilitate this for you, we've hired the service consultant to run through a system that he's developed over the last 34 years. He's put a lot of hours into it, and we've invested in that system so we can impart that with you, our partners. So I hope you enjoy it, and I'm going to hand you over to Bill. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Brian. Okay, guys. Yeah, I apologize for running late. As you know, I'm Bill Sandham. I'm an independent business consultant, and I specialize in developing system integrators. So I'm really blessed to be part of the Samsung strategy. Their strategy is to build their brand, and there is no better way to build a brand than to build the base. So how many in the room are actually installers and system integrators of CCTV? Yeah? Okay, anybody here? System integrators, CCTV? All right. So guys, you're all in business, and you know how competitive it is out there? And it kind of can come down to the price, and it's, I'm going to train you today to not really go there with the be all about the price. I want it to be all about the client. And I'll share with you a philosophy and a strategy which resulted in a frustration I've had since 1983, since I've been in the business, where people are trying to sell a CCTV system and not solve the problem. Kind of makes sense? It's like trying to me, my analogy is, if you go into the doctor and you're kind of like this, and meanwhile you're going to the doctor because you've got a migraine, the salesman will say, ah, we're running a special on hip replacements. Oh, we got such a sweet deal, 36 months, no deposits, it's a sweet deal, you can take it, includes maintenance. That's a salesman, right? So we're on about asking questions. You know, you go to the doctor, he asks you questions, and he wants to know about you, and he wants to care about you. So today is really all about that. So the agenda for today is to understand why we're here. We're here as a strategy to build the Mia Samsung base, and the way to build the Mia Samsung base is for the authorized, licensed distributors of the product to massively increase their turnover and their profitability, and not actually increase the amount of staff they employ. Sounds good? Do more sales, more GP, same staff, using a system. Because we're on about a sales aid system, which is specifically designed to develop you as a business, and then hence the loyalty to the brand. This system is available only through Mia Samsung. They have got a regional master license. So the people that work for Mia know that this is now going to be available to their base. And shortly we're going to be expanding it because we want it to cover PABX and
office automation
so that the philosophy will be the same. So we're going to show you about the handbook, and we're going to discuss the click to quote, as it's called. But also in doing this, you're all going to be part of today, and I'm going to be handing out some stuff. That's why I asked you if you had a pen earlier, because then what you can do is actually live this as a role play, as if you're an end user and as if you're a client, and you understand the risk of your business. Everybody good with that? Okay. So I just want to explain the model. Apologize for the image. I don't understand why. But this is a process that will be available to certain of the system integrators. Today we're talking of click to quote. We've got power hours, training, mentoring in the field, how to do surveys, which we're doing today, the presentation and how to win and present the deal on the day, right? What is the average time it takes to get a quote out to the client? Guys, you 4 to 6 hours. Who does it live in front of the client? Who actually sits in front of the client and does it live right there, right then, and can get a signed deal?
Nobody.
Okay? These guys say. Okay, well done. So that to me is the philosophy, and in order to do that, you've got to be able to understand the risk. So it's not about, to me, it's not about selling those 16 cameras or those 46 cameras. To me, it's about understanding the risk. And that is really the premise of getting a relationship. Because if you're in sales, you'll know the guy with the relationship gets the deal. And the stronger your relationship, the less the focus on the end price, because they feel that they trust you. And trust, as you know, is everything. And who's in sales, by the way, in the room? Everybody's in sales. If you're in a relationship, you're in sales. It doesn't matter. And by the way, just on that, us men, we, in the relationship, we must always have the last word. Is that what would you say? And do you know what the last word is? If you're married, the last word is yes, dear. Absolutely true. So we're gonna take you through some steps of how this works. We're going to go on to the risk survey handbook. So I'm going to hand these out, and please, anybody that isn't taking the package from Mia, must hand this one back to me at the end of the talk. Okay? But staff obviously retain it. So there's got to be a measurable tool. Anybody that understands management and understands building a business knows where performance is measured, performance improves. So I've just given you, these are stats based on actual facts. I can't tell you how many years it's taken to get these numbers like this. They look really simple when you see it. I'm just going to talk you through it. If you have a turnover, you can either call it a consultant, or you can call it your business. If your goal is to do 1 million rand a month, this is the kind of workload and this is the kind of information that you're going to need to put together. The pipeline that you're going to need to achieve 1 million rand is 12.5 million. Now I'm on about a real pipeline, and to qualify for a pipeline, you've got to have been there, seen it, done the survey, met the client, understood his needs. There's too many people that put, oh, we tendered on the University of Pretoria at 7 million, and they put the 7 million rand in the pipeline. They actually don't even know if they're compliant. You know what I mean? So I can help all of you with that. Deals required. We do know the average order value is 200K. If your business has got a different model and your average order value is higher or lower than 200K, then it makes the figures change proportionately. What else do we know? That you've got to have to make 25 appointments. We know what happens. Five of them will blow you out. You're going to get in front of 20 people. Out of the 20 people, you're going to do 15 demos. Now, it's easy to do a demo because we got a smartphone. We got a tablet, we got a laptop, or you actually take them to a client site. But if you've been in front of 15 people that can make a decision, and by the way, the rule of sales, you never take a no off someone that can't give you a yes. Think about that. Don't take a no if they can't give you a yes. So if somebody says, I can't put you through, he's not interested, and it's the receptionist, that's not a contact. Would you guys agree? It's got to be somebody that has the authority to say no or yes. So out of all that, you will get your deals. And that target applies to one person or one business. If you've got seven consultants in the business, then your target for that business is to actually do 7 million a month. And you might think this is telephone numbers, but I do work for companies that do well in excess of that per month. from this kind of, obviously national companies, from this kind of sales. So you can see we've got a part of the strategy is to give you tools that you can analyze your effectiveness in the market. We've already agreed it's very competitive, but it's more than the price. And if at the end of today you think it's still about the price, then I didn't really achieve my goal with you today. Is that fair? Okay. So let's get onto this onto the handbook. Right. So you've all got this in your hand. So let's just talk about the concept of going to a client prepared. Most people, when I was a system integrator, by the way, I'm no longer a system integrator. Most people go to the client and they just have a notepad and a pen, and or a price list. We're on about preparation, about going to the client and actually understanding what you're doing, doing research, finding out who are the other stakeholders, and whilst you're there, make sure you get permission to take photos. Photos carry so much information. You know, when you're walking around, you've got your smartphone, and you want to remember maybe the till or the roller door, you know, whatever the guys are doing. You want to understand, and you reflect on the photo, and you might see something that you missed originally. So very, very simple. Refer to earn, R2E. You see that here? Refer to earn. We all want the lead. Would you say the lead is one of the most valuable things you can get? Yeah? No matter what, you know, no matter what you are, if you're a professional and you want to build a business, you've got to get a lead. So you can have a professional system to set up so you can actually quantify that lead, and then the guy that brings the lead makes it a warm lead, and then he gets a finder's fee. But it's a philosophy of building your business through people bringing stuff to your business to help you build the business. It's a refer to earn. And the name of the survey and the date. So already when you're sitting in front of a client, he can see that you've got a differentiator because you're prepared. As opposed to, oh, we don't have a pen, we don't have a pencil. Oh, I'll remember everything. I want you to understand that you're no longer selling a CCTV system. You're no longer selling booms, turnstiles, office automation. What you're doing is you're actually serving and you're solving the client's issues. And the only way to solve his issues to me is to ask questions. Yeah? All agree? So how do you ask questions, and what the hell questions do you ask? This is how easy it can be. This is how easy it can be. Right, so open to page 2 in your book. I want you to write in this book, right, who's recently seen a client that is suffering from some kind of theft? You've seen a client? Right, okay. What were their concerns? Thank you, that's better. Yeah, whilst we're going through the slides. What were their concerns? Do you remember what their concerns were?
Mostly the theft in the company.
The theft in the company. By who, did they say?
Employees.
By the employees. Do you know the value of the theft?
About 20 grand a month.
20 grand a month. So, okay, that's good. That's really good intel. So the concern was? The concern is that their staff are stealing from them. Okay, guys, you also had a client with the risk. What were their concerns?
Diesel theft from the tankers.
Diesel theft from the tankers. Okay, did you get any specifics? Any figures?
4 million a month, 3 trucks.
Oh my gosh. Okay, that's going to put them out of business.
Well, they turn over fucking loads.
Okay. Well, nobody can bleed 4 million rand a month, but yeah. So which is 2%. So their concern is theft of diesel because it's untraceable. It's black gold. It just goes, and you never know. You never know where it went. So when you're in front of a client, you'd say, "What are your concerns about your business? Theft." Sergio, you saw a client. Was it you? Somebody else put their arm up. No? Right. So, to understand their concerns, and their concerns can be more than theft. We're going to see on the other sheet just now. Now, the R is the risk. So you've asked them about their concerns, or it can be, you can use the C for cause. What is the cause of the inquiry? You've called us. We're here. Bang. We're here. I'm here from Mia Samsung. We've come to see you. What are your, you know, what caused the interest? Oh, we were robbed yesterday. So you've got a cause of an interest. What are the risks? The guys with the trucks, what were the risks to the client? Well, yeah. All those, all of the above. And the risk is also 4 million rand, because you've now got a specific number. Yeah? And your client's risk? 20K, right. So the risk is 20K. And then the best thing to do is to build on the risks. Now, this I question, which to me is the decision whether you're going to go or stay. And my opinion is the top sales guys in the world are the ones that have those things that hang, to leave immediately. I can test some of you guys. Who has actually just stood up and left the meeting because they're not happy with something, or they think they're being used, or they think that you're dealing with a tire kicker? All the time. Stand up and say, thank you, sir. So how do you know? We call it a trial close. How do you know if you're actually dealing at the right level and if the risk is real? I say you ask this question, implication. So you've done a risk, you've met the client, you've introduced yourself, he knows who you are, you kind of done some research, you know who he is. Now you're saying to him, we all know that there's a problem in your company. What's the implication if you do nothing about it? Think about it. So if he comes back, you say, oh man, we turn over 200 million, 4 million rand. Sorry, sir, come in. 4 million rand a month is nothing to us. There's no implication. Then leave. Simple as that. So, thank you. So the idea is, you're trying to find out really where he's hurting with a question about implication. Think about it. Think about anything. If you know the implication, he's actually giving you information of where his issues are. Simple example, we had a transport company. I was doing the risk survey on behalf of a company, and I said to the clients, what's the cause? They've just stolen a box of iPhones. What's the risk? I think it was like 77,000 rand for the box of iPhones. I said, what's the implication then on your business if you do nothing about this theft? Some people would say, well, there's a 77,000 rand loss. The client, because I was dealing with the MD, said, if we lose this client, we lose 4 million rand a month in revenue. That's the implication. We cannot have this happen again. We must stop this happening in the business. So your implication is part of your trial close, but it's part of your connection to find out what is the value that you're going to offer, because he's going to give you the value. Think about it, right? And it's also it's like a hard question in a soft way, because now you're trying to find out from him, does he trust you? Because if he's like still like this, then you've got a feeling he's not trusting you. Yeah. Now the M is your method. What method is the client using? Were your guys using any method? Yeah. Okay, so the method is kind of tracing, tracking, following private investigations, and then filming that evidence. Okay, fantastic. So there is a method, and some people say, "Oh, we've got armed response." Oh, that's great. I thought we were dealing with theft during business hours. So how's armed response going to help you? So try and understand their methods, because a lot of people have been ill-advised and they don't really know why they put stuff in. It's your job to save them and to help them. And then the last one is the expectancy. So this is when you're saying, please, sir, what is your expectancy of us in, you know, helping you, working, putting an installation, putting a system together? What is your expectation? And his expectation was, could be, I want to stop diesel theft completely. I want to stop the theft of 20K a month. I want to get those clowns out of my business, safer word. And I want to do the right thing, because if you've got any bad apples in your business, then your business is going to go downhill. So how difficult is it to go through those questions? Would anybody have any difficulty saying that to a client?
No.
And you'll find that then you've got a structure, as opposed.
I'd use proper structure.
It's a proper structure, as opposed to going in there to say, oh. Hi, I'm from, I'm Jake's from this company, and by the way, we've got the latest CCTV, and we can help you with theft, which is the standard way of selling. So how are you going to do anything different than that? You're going to do the relationship sell. You're going to become across as a systems consultant, a true consultant, and in any case, a consultant is the guy that's asking the questions. So everybody okay with the five? Just to go back to the front page, can you see on the front page there's a figure of 6,900 Rand? Yeah? How many of us here actually charge for our time? Client says, I want a quote. What do we do? Oh, yeah. He wants a quote. I'm saying that your time, your IP, your system is worth a fortune. If you can stop a 2 million rand, 4 million rand a month theft, this 6,900 rand, it pales into insignificancy. Yeah? Make sense? Because now you're saying, if the client decides, they can have a proper risk survey. So when you get to the red line, this is where you say to the client, you see there's a red line there. That is a cue for me to say, if I can help you or if I can't help you. If I can't help you, I'm going to leave. Is that cool? And they go, oh, sweet. They like that, because then they feel there's no pressure. But as soon as you tell them that there's now an easy way out, but based on your questions, if you truly believe you can help the client and you truly believe you can solve his issues, then you can mention that if they require, there is a full risk survey. And part of that is this little thing. So we're all going to do a role play now, just to show you how simple this can be. So you can decide how you use this. You can use this as a chargeable system, or you can use it in your first meeting. It really depends how much time you've got. So everybody get their page 4 together. Who can use a page 4? Page 4. Everybody, you on page 4? Okay. Now you see there's protection, production, profitability. According to me, there are only 3 reasons why people buy surveillance security systems, and it falls under one of those 3. As Brian said, I've been doing this since 1983, so it's been a long time, and in all those years, I haven't found anything that falls outside those 3 things. If you guys have got a new way of theft that falls outside those 3, you could say, buying signals, then that's fine. So let's just do a role play on one of the 3. And anybody want to decide which one we do?
Protection.
That's a good one. So protection. Think about a client that you've seen, or if you haven't, think about a premises that you know well. Can everybody picture a premises that they know that there's crime issues? It could be a client's, it could be your own. And for this little role play now, can you think of a premises where there's a risk? Yeah? Think of one? So now you're going to ask the client for him to mark out of 10 what his feeling is on this. Okay? So you say, from naught, which is I'm not really concerned, to 10, which is it's mission critical to my business, how would you score a reduction in the human element in your risk control? Give it a number out of 1 to 10. Just write it in there. Can you think of a number? Yeah? Got a number? So put your score in under number 1. Write your score in. How important is it to have early warning of any breach of the perimeter? By the way, does everybody understand the question? When I say early warning of a breach, do you guys know what I mean? Yeah? If somebody's already got over your wall, it's too late. They're in. If they got over the perimeter, they're in. So early warning is basically that. Like if this was a perimeter, if somebody, and I'm on the outside, the unsafe side, if somebody's coming up, I want to know now. So you say to the client, how important is it to know if somebody's actually casing you, you know, before they come in and do their stuff? And then you get a score out of 10. Is it important to have the faces of every person wishing to gain access? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. Do you want the number plates of everybody that comes into your premises? Score it. Do you want constant surveillance of the grounds, portals, and turnstiles? So what you're doing here is you're now expanding his idea of the risk in his business, because he's thinking, well, we were here to talk about the outside of the business. Now he's on about my doors. Now he's on about my roller shut. Now he's on about the booms. Now he's on. So you're starting to build, you could say, build the size of the deal, build the size of the solution, build the size of the engagement, yeah, in that meeting. Motion detection of illegal entry and ability to see in total darkness. Now, ability to see in total darkness. Then you know you're dealing with after-hours crime, and you could be even going thermal with your solution. Security guards assisted with their duties. Some companies, and this month I've done a write-up in High Tech Security Magazine for one of my clients, page 22, and it's about security guards being replaced with their duties. Okay? Can be done. If you understand the brief, you understand the risk, you can go to a site and you can put 100% technology and not have anybody there. Ability to observe criminals from a point of safety. If you go to a housing complex, we all go there, office park, you drive up, you've got the booms, and sometimes they've got cameras. The very person that's greeting you is the person that's protecting the business or the entity or the estate. If you take him out, you're in. So that's another thing, is to train the client on to understand where is a point of safety, where they're exposing their guys, and to have a system that calls for help during a breach and the exact time and date of these exceptions. So that's just an example of the kind of mentality. Because have we mentioned a camera yet? Have we mentioned a price?
No.
Have we tried to sell anything? So you see what is happening psychologically, because you know sales is scientific and it's psychological. And the more information you get from the client, the closer you get to them. And the closer you get to them, the closer you are to your goal of winning them as a client. And have you noticed the price really hasn't come into it? He isn't saying, I've got a price for 32 cameras and it's cheaper than you, because now you've engaged in a risk conversation. Now to me, that is number one. Because as soon as you start offering, if the guy says to you, We had a guy here this morning. He's given us a price on a 32 camera solution and two turnstiles and four booms. I want you to have the presence of mind to say, did he do a risk survey, sir? Sorry, I don't know who gave you what you need. May I just ask some questions? Because you can bet your bottom dollar your competition hasn't. He's just gone in there and said, you need this, you need this, you need this, you need this. Okay? I'll give you a real example. I was a guest speaker at a talk at the breweries, and there was, I think, 56 managers, senior managers at this conference, all shirt and tie, and I said, who's got a working knowledge of CCTV? Pretty much everybody put their hand up. I said, all right, who thinks CCTV is a waste of time? And they pretty much put their hands up. I'm going, ooh, this is going to be a challenge. So I picked a guy out of the audience and I said, oh, sorry, sir, where's your depot? Da, 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 da. Can you remember when the CCTV guy came to your premises and did the survey? Yes, I did. Can you remember when he went to your dispatch bay? Yes, I can. What happened then? Now, we walked around and I said to him, I want a camera up there to watch my dispatch bay. What's the very next word that came out of that guy's mouth? The salesman said, that's okay. I said, that's where it all went wrong. He should have said, why? Who says? What's your intention with that camera? Well, I actually want to be able to see, I want to be able to see the crowns. If you look at a bottle, there's a shiny bit there, which is where the fluid is, and then there's air in the middle, right? So if you put a camera up there, are you going to be able to see that crown? I said, that's where it all went wrong, because we're on about people stealing empty bottles, having full bottles, stealing empty bottles, all in a cage, all in a crate, all looks the same. Meanwhile, there's a difference. Some are full, some are empty. And it's the ability to know how is that processed and where does that beer go. That's just an example. So the ideal situation is when a client tells you that they want something, please understand they don't know what they don't know. And they don't know what they don't know until you ask them the question. And asking the question is really your job. Because if you're in a meeting, whoever's asking the question is? Yeah. If anybody's ever got home late after a boys' night out, is somebody controlling that the next moment? Like the what time do you call this? Where have you been? Why didn't you ring? So the person asking the questions is totally in control. And you have to respond to that. So that's something to remember. So this whole thing is about getting that relationship going. And trust me, the more understanding that you have with the risk of that client, the more likely to you to close the sale. Because remember, the strategy of MIA is to make all their dealer base assist in closing the sale. And if you go in there with the same methodology that you've been doing for all these years, you're going to have the same result. We're saying, bring it bang up to date. This is the concept of consultancy selling. And by the way, this is a book. I don't know, Brian, if you know this book. It's called Let's Get Real or Let's Not Play. And it is by Mahan Khalsa. And I believe that this is the best instructional consulting sales system I've ever seen, and I've just read about every book, done webinars, and to me this is the way to go forward.
We've got four proven systems that we can share with you. One is warehousing, receiving, dispatching. The other is weighbridges. The other is perimeter, and the fifth is tilt solutions.
I'm going to do that today.
These have been proven over many years, and if you use these systems, you can take this IP and apply it to one of those areas. You can implement it. For example, in our dispatching area in MIA, I think we've got four cameras, five cameras. We don't need it, we need two. Positioned correctly will do the job 100%. So I'm going to leave you in Paul's hands.
Thank you. So I'm just giving you a taste of the power. Thank you, Brian. The taste of the power. We're not going to go through the whole document today. The idea is to tell you that there is a system. If you follow the system, it works. It's pretty much going to guarantee you a better relationship and a better understanding of the risk. No longer is it about price. He knows you're sincere and you're there to help him. So you've even got a little scorecard to do his perimeter. We're not going to do it, but I've got to tell you this. We've got a red line again. And again, you know, we were on about the confidence to leave. This red line, this is really your business. The surveillance and then the teeth. On average, because we're doing commercial, retail, industrial, we're not doing domestic. If he hasn't sorted out these issues, then he hasn't really addressed the crime and he has to really put those together. Which is his perimeter. Does he even have a perimeter? Does he have a wall? Has he got lighting? Has he got an electric fence? And does he have security? So these are all important elements that most commercial, retail, industrial businesses already have in place, but yet they still suffer from crime. So this is where you come in. So after the red line is where your business takes charge. And you've got an effective intruder alarm. You can score the guy on what he's got and how you can help him. Whilst we're not doing intruder alarms, the video motion and the video analytics software in the Samsung surveillance waxes that 100%. You can actually pretty much tell the guy he's going to get visual verification of anything that moves on his premises 24/7, on his mobile, on his laptop, via email, via SMS, and even to the control room. Very, 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 very powerful. Then, this then leads us into the page 6 and 7. I'm going to do this live in Excel just now. This is the click to quote, and this is the real. This is where the meat and potatoes are of getting into the deal. You can walk around the site, like you can understand. Okay, well, according to what I've seen, you're going to need 6 box cameras, and then this becomes the start of your project sheet, because you can't forget any projects. You can't forget a product. We've had projects that go wrong. You get to site, and the guy says, or the team says, oh, where's the monitor? No, it's got to be there. Have you looked?
Duh.
It's like this big. Yeah, it's not there. Because somebody forgot the monitor, or the brackets, or the RJ45s, or the saddles, or the boots, or the connectors, or the Cat 5. It happens all the time. People forget things. If you get a job in Nelspruit, let's say you've got to do a 32 camera installation in Nelspruit, and you send the team there, and they get there, and they're short of, it can be a switch. The system, you can install a whole system, but without a switch, you've just got equipment on the wall. So we're going to show you how the click to quote will help you get efficient with that. And you can imagine this now being used in office automation. Right. Now, who has a working knowledge of CCTV here? We're going to go to page 9. You understand CCTV? Yeah? Do you understand the laws of CCTV, guys? Let's try and share this with you. If you can explain this to a client live, you are going to get an extra level of trust, because how often do a client says, oh, we've had like 3 or 4 companies quoting us? Yeah? If you can say to them, which of the laws of surveillance are you using? Which law of surveillance are you using? If he says, I have no idea what you're on about, then you realize you're not up against a worthy opponent. You're up against somebody that's just trying to sell the deal. So I'm just going to do a quick idea of this. It is on that page. If this is the monitor, if he's going for protection, you've got to produce an image of 10% of the screen height. So it doesn't matter if they're black, white, male or female, it's irrelevant. If they occupy 10% of the screen height on that camera, on the screen, you can help him protect his business, which means you can put a camera, if it's the new Samsung thermal camera, You can put that like 228 meters, I think. 228 meters from the pole, you can look down a perimeter. If you're using megapixel cameras, you can average 66 to 80 meters. Depends on the reflectance of the ground, the field of view, the trees, foliage, and the shape of the perimeter. But if you you're going to say law one is protection and it's 10%. Law two, now this is where you really, really got to help the guy. Law two is 50% and it is recognition. So recognition would be, if I looked at this CCTV system that's running in here, and I go through the footage when everybody's finished, and I see Sergio walking past the camera. If Sergio is 50% of the screen or more, I will sign an affidavit to say he nicked my cell phone. Are you with me? Because remember, in most cases of theft, we are up against the public or the staff?
Staff.
Who can remember the figures from the South African hospitality industry, the theft figures? 74% staff plus 25% absolutely the manager. So, oh, well, I'm actually doing well in my business. I'm going to go and buy myself a fast food shop. Happy days. But I'm not going to resign yet. I'm going to keep my job. I'm just going to buy it, and I'm going to put a manager in. Well, you can kiss your thing goodbye to 25% of your business. So you need to recognize. Because remember, everybody that works for that person, everybody that manages, is known by the operator. So there's no point producing pictures that big of somebody that's in your workforce. Like in, you know, the people put CCTV and they put it in a warehouse and they'll put a 3.6 lens camera with a 1.2 megapixel lens. The guy's 40 meters away, he's this big on the screen, and they'll say, oh no, that's Frank. You can say what you like, it's not going to stand up in court. Okay, so that's law number two. And then law number three is 120% to 160% of the screen height. Well, how does that work? Well, excuse my little stick men, but if you watch SABC3 and you see the news, you see Peter Ndoro. Kind of know who I mean, right? And so it's kind of this shot, and that is when you're dealing with rape, when you're dealing with serious crimes, murder, drugs, robbery, stabbings, hijackings. You actually, because you don't know this person, you have no idea who they are, but you've got to give that to SAP or certain people that I know, and they will find that individual and they will thank him personally. But you need that good a resolution. So if you find you're competing against three or four companies, ask the client, which law of surveillance are they using? And if they give you that blank look, please say, can you humor me for 5 minutes? I'll just explain how the laws work. Because then when you get to another closing question, you see on the sheet here it says, use law one, use law two, use law three. For those of you that love doing trial closes to see if the deal is live, if you say to a client, shall we use law one, or which laws shall we use for your business? Just do a role play here. Which laws should we use on your business?
As a matter of fact, let's discuss it, because let's use our environment.
Yes.
That we just spoke about now.
Yes, a good one.
Yeah, yeah.
So which laws do you think apply to this company?
Well, our current law is that one.
Right.
Oh.
Which is 10%.
Yes.
Which means you can't use it as evidence.
Okay.
Yeah? So tick that one. Tick that box there. Okay. Now, do you want to be able to recognize these people?
Absolutely.
So tick that one. Do you think most of your problem is coming from staff or from strangers?
Staff.
So we're happy with that. So the interaction then is saying, you the end user, I'm now the Mia Samsung dealer, and I'm here to help you. Now you are telling me I will use the two laws with my system.
Right.
Are you with me? So when we walk to your dispatch bay, you see how this is working now? Or when we go to the till, which I'm going to do just now, I know that if I deliver a clear enough picture that you can see and you can recognize every single one of your staff on this system, will you sign it off?
Good question, yeah.
You see? You see how this goes into a close? It's not just a handbook. This is telling you how to sell.
Yeah.
And it's training you how to sell and keeping the system live. You like it? Works like a bomb. And then the last bit. I have to show you this because sometimes in order to win a deal, you've got to deal with an existing installation. Yeah? CCTV has been sold. Since I came to South Africa, I can't even tell you how many hundreds of thousands of cameras that I've sold over the years. I can't even start to guess. And there are many, many CCTV systems that were sold by salesmen that didn't understand the risk. And I was one of them in those days. I've had to teach myself all this just from getting it wrong. School of hard knocks. You've got to learn the hard way. So you're going to have to come up again. And the guy says, oh, I've got a system already. So you've got to be able to see this little sheet here. I know it looks really confusing. Just concentrate on one square. So let's say here, this is camera 11. So we're going to write in your camera 11. I can't even read this bloody thing. So dodgy. Camera 11. The type, it's a dome camera. The risk area. So you can do this with a client, or you can do it with his risk manager. What is the risk area? The risk area is till 4. What's the field of view? Does he want general surveillance or does he want to recognize the cache here? You see how this is starting to come together now. So you want him to recognize the cache here, and then the little arrows are just to show you, once you're looking at the picture, do you need to move the camera up, down, left, right? And these are the things to check on the camera. And you can pass or fail it. And also sell him lightning protection, all in that one little document. And if he's got more than 16 cameras, you just photocopy it and use it more times. You see all these little tools that you're going with. So only consultants go in with stuff like this. Salesmen don't. Because now you've got to invest time in the guy. And you're only investing time because in the first 5 questions, you decided he's worth investing time in. Otherwise, you would have got up and you would have left. Okay? So then, before we go into the click to quote, I just want to share one of the 4 solutions of how to protect theft at a till point, and the kind of things that people get wrong. Okay. By the way, who's worked at a till point? Who's done security at a point of sale? Okay. So you kind of know the things that go on. So what information do we need? We need law to the cashier. She works for you, okay? Shall I just move this? So you need law 2 for the cashier. You need law 2 for the packer. A lot of the supermarkets now have people packing. Remember, the goods are coming this way. The client who stood here, is this the brother, sister, mother, father, son, daughter, friend of this little love triangle going on? Because then that's collusion. And collusion is a massive, massive, massive area of theft. And more importantly, are they wearing a cap? I went to a site this very morning. They've done a complete refit of the site. It's a massive, massive supermarket. And as I walk in, the guys have done the cameras and they put them directly above the till. You got to love it, eh, in this day and age. So what view do they get? Of, now they want to prosecute the cashier. This is the view they get. There is their cap. And that's meant to be the peak. And that's the shoulders and then that's the feet. So you, oh yeah, yeah, no, that's definitely Mary. Because you can see by the red cap. She wears a red cap. Is this going to stand up in court? So we know that you need certain more information. So you need to know this, you need to know this, you need to know this. You need to see the transaction. You need to see what goods are being sold. You need to see what was scanned. You need to see what the quantity was. You need to see what was packed into the bag. You need the time and the date of this information.
But
and you need...
What is the ideal position then?
I'm going to get there.
Okay,
cool. Okay? So then all that information goes together on one frame. So when you look at a frozen image, all that information is there in a 25th of a second or a 6th of a second, however, whatever speed you've got it recording on. That, in order to achieve that, you've got to understand the risk and you've got to understand how they steal, and you've got to understand what the different Samsung megapixel settings are. Okay? So that's part of the product training, and to know, is this 2 megapixel? You look at the lighting in the store, you look at the reflectance, and you, some people have stores which are so busy that they're selling things here. There's things for sale here, and there's little banners special here above the till. You've got to be able to go to the retailer and say, take all the banners down, please, or just turn them 90 degrees, because we've had situations where you have opening special this way, and all you can see with the camera is opening special. They turn the sign 90 degrees, you see, you pass the sign, and you see to the risk. So what we found out over the years, just to answer your question on the angles, if this is a typical plan view of a shop layout,
from above.
So now this is like an architect's kind of idea. So he's got till 1, till 2, till 3, cashier, and the sale is coming down that way. You've got a camera here, and you've got a camera here, and you've got a camera here. On average, the center line of this till, the camera goes and it watches that till. And it watches that till because the customer who's facing you is walking towards you. You've got the transaction. You've got all that information in one. And the angle of this camera is a... So this is about a 45 degree installation angle. And then from the height... Then you need, it's approximately a 30 degree rake on the gimbal on the dome cameras. By the way, you only use dome cameras? Never, ever, ever use a bullet camera in retail because it's too directional. And you want people to, you don't want them to know exactly what you can see. So you use a dome, it's more discreet. And for the people that are honest, they don't see it anyway. They're just there to shop. So that just gives you an idea, and based on the size of the till and the size of the items that they sell, like if they're selling boxes of cooking oil, then you can say, okay, I can put a Samsung 2 megapixel in. But if they're selling small things, small high-value things, the more megapixel you can give, the clearer the image and the more details you're going to get about that theft. All right, with me so far? Okay, good. Right, now we're going to go on to, we're going to do a live click to quote now. Yeah, I think we can do the lights now. How are we doing on time? Perfect. So the idea is that once you understand the risk, once you understand the client's needs, you've got this on your tablet, you've got this on your laptop, whatever you're going to use in front of the client, this is now where you sit with him and you say, right, sir, we've had a look at your business and we've agreed that you need, let's say, four box cameras. We need six dome cameras. We need maybe, you need 22 bullet cameras to watch the rollers and the outside area. Two hidden cameras, four pan tilt zooms, and two pilot's monitors. Now, why am I calling it a pilot's monitor? It's a whole mindset. When you understand the risk and you understand how much a month that client is losing, if you give him a system which just gets locked away in a cupboard and isn't driven and isn't part of his like risk solution, you're not really helping him. Try and get the idea that, do you realize that the captain of the plane, the pilot, is the one with the most information? So make sure that you have a risk discussion about what are you going to do with the risk? What are you going to do about this? Because this is going to generate real evidence. Based on what you've told me and what we've shared about your risk, this is going to generate real evidence. So we're talking about the concept of a pilot monitor. So is it going to be recorded, and is there going to be a backup PC? Video analytics. Does everybody know what I mean by video analytics? In a word, it's a system that you can set a tripwire, so you can have a camera up there. Let's say this is a supermarket and you've got a camera and the cleaners come in at 6 o'clock and they're not allowed into the CD section, but they're allowed in to clean the food aisles. Put a Samsung camera with a very focal lens and you literally draw a tripwire. So the cleaners are allowed in at 5 in the morning and they know they're not allowed to go into the hi-fi section. As soon as one of them goes in, they didn't actually cross anything physical. So it's called a virtual perimeter. So it's software, yeah?
Just a quick question. Your rental 36 months and then you have a fast day.
Yes.
Is that according to the CRS rates currently or to what rates?
Whatever rates they've given us to load.
Okay, so it's loaded.
Yeah, it's completely customizable to whatever your CRS rates are.
Okay.
So I'm just understanding the video analytics is really a software that in the old days, believe it or not, when we first did analog surveillance, we said, oh, we've got this amazing thing called video motion detection. But guess what? A shadow, you know, like a cloud coming over? We used to do perimeter systems, and then because of the bright South African sun, the cloud had come over, the system would have gone into alarm. How's that possible? Because it doesn't know. So over the years, the scientists have said, we need to analyze this. We need video analytics to say if it's a cloud, if it's a human, what are we watching here? So the clouds go over. You can move things in front of the camera, as we all know. But this is actually going to tell you if there's a human there. Now, if you're doing the maths, you realize if you got something with that intelligence, you don't need a guard to do that. Yeah? So let's give it video analytics. We'll give him four of those. And then we'll put a text overlay on four of the roller doors, because we want to be able to scan the goods into the roller. So you see there's blue and white numbers and there's red and white numbers. So the red numbers are prompting you to say, based on what you've put above, this is what you're going to get as a system. It's a 38 camera system. You're going to need 11 rolls of cable. And by the way, we're going to be saying we need 2 double goosenecks. We need 4 of those special cameras on the perimeter. 2 of the PTZs are going on candy sticks. We need to disc cut across the drive. You know, people have got paving. We need to disc cut 22 meters across the drive. We're going to need 8 bags of concrete, and we're going to need 217 meters of 20 mil PVC coax, and back to the top. So then you're in front of the client, you click to quote, and then this starts to bring up now the value of this project, and you're having a discussion about the value of the project. And you're doing this live. Because remember, you said to the client, what is your budget? He says, we don't know. We don't have a budget. How often do they say that when you're trying to sell? We don't know how much we're going to spend. But as soon as you hit them with a price, suddenly they got a budget. No, we can't afford that. Oh, yeah, well, that's about right. So this is where, so now you are in the driving seat now. You've been asking the questions. Now you've got to a number. Now you're saying to them, based on what you've told us, this project is worth, I've got nearly R500,000 of vehicle surveillance. I was doing a test this morning. So let's say that we've got the vehicle surveillance as well, the Samsung, you know, the cameras in the car. So we've got so your entire risk is going to be covered. It's a R1.3 million project, which is going to set you back R23,000 a month. We got a R4 million loss. R23,000 a month. If you're in business, what are you going to do? You got a R4 million a month loss. Are you going to invest R23,000 a month to protect it? Absolutely. You see, now the whole meeting has changed, because now you've got a number. Now you've got black and white figures, and now you know if you're dealing at the right level. What is it going to take to get this deal signed? Ask the question, because now you can. And remember that your final price is going to be subject to project management, technical manager kind of survey, where they go behind the scenes. And the guy says, no, but I want to know what I'm going to get for my money. So then on your click to quote, you're going to show him this page here. All your client details are loaded there. All your details are loaded there. And then this ends up to be this. And once you know how to drive the system, just hand that one around. And Sergio, hand that. So once you know how to drive the system, you'll be able to produce this quote in 6 seconds. And that the client can sign that off there and then, because it's got all the budget figures in. You can actually do a trial close. Which one do you want to go to? Brian?
I think I just want to mention 2 things. This quote is printed in A3. It will stand out.
Yes.
You've got good, better, and best, 3 options for the client. It's by making your quote stand out. So when we've this machine, this quote we printed on this machine, which is an Epson, but you can select your coverage. So right now we're printing at 10% coverage, but make your quote vibrant. When you do these quotes, print them at 15% coverage. Really doesn't make a big difference on this machine. But now you're giving the client an A3 quote with everything in, end to end. What do you think is going to sound next? Or some pastel quote.
That's exactly what it comes down to. So can you see the power that you have, like, live in front of the client, and the edge that you have over your competition? Because most guys, remember, they've gone in there with sometimes just a pen and pencil, piece of paper, and they say the classic thing. The guy says, how much are we in for? Oh, I'll get back to you. I'll email you a quote. I'm saying that if the client is worthy of it, you can do the deal right now. We've had situations. In fact, the very, 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 very first time I used this system, the client, I was the third company there. I did the quote in 12 minutes because it was the very first use of it. And he signed the deal there and then. It's 656,000 Rand. And the other companies hadn't even got back to him after 2 weeks. And he wasn't allowed to trade his site until he put his perimeter system in. So if you've got a tool that can do that, that is what we're talking about. Brian, I think that is the main purpose of the session today, is to say that anybody connected with Mia Samsung has a tool to use. It's like a two-hit tool to drive their business, to grow their business, to understand the risk. There's training available, Brian. There's training available on all this stuff. Yeah?
Yes, just we're getting on live again now.
Okay, fantastic. Right. So there's training available on everything that we've discussed today. We can do a group training. We can do training within your business, training on site. And then the idea is every single time you go to a site survey, you whip out your risk survey handbook, get all the details, get the buy-in from the client, and then whip out your click to quote and then go from there. Thank you very much, guys. Thanks. My pleasure. Thank you.
Before we close out, who wants a copy of click to quote? So basically, you've got the site survey and you get the click to quote product, but you're going to get also the design system for the three areas that we spoke about earlier, the warehousing, the fetch, as well as the weigh bridges, as well as the perimeter. Now, guys, we have products that do that. We have our Tico product that we distribute, as well as the Axon product that we distribute. You have the options of either one or two. And that's for the video analytics part. Now, the idea of click to quote was to give you a system, easy and professional, that you could follow. I mean, the biggest request we have, Mia, have is site surveys. Every day, we're doing 3-4 site surveys with dealers. And the reason is, guys are scared to make a mistake and cost them money. With a site survey booklet, it forms a system from A to Z. This becomes a system spec. This system spec is loaded in to click the quote, which has your quotation.
Yeah.
Now, click the quote's got a peripheral page which Bill didn't show you. It does your elbows, it does a lot of the material that's normally forgotten out of the quote. So the idea here, click the quote is a comprehensive tool that allows you not to leave anything out. So the GP that you see, the GP you make.
But that includes all expenses.
Because the optional extras, everything is there.
Yeah, that's a good question. Will it include expenses? It does include all the time you've taken to do this, your travel, your time, your printing of the quote, all your personal time in winning that contract is already built into the deal. So what it means to the guys, they got meat on the bone. So if you close a deal at this price, you must know you're in for about a 42% GP. I don't know what you're averaging at the moment, but a 42% GP sounds a sweet deal to us. Yeah? Especially in this competitive market.
I think
thanks.
You give the client options.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you've got the choice. You look at the proposal and he decides. You'll probably find most clients that are like me, they're going to probably say, I want the best at the good price. It gives you negotiation room, you understand? And the goal is to get a system that covers our entire range. The solution sets will become with a system. But our goal today was to introduce it and launch it. What we need is, if you're interested, is come and see your sales team, present this to your sales team, teach them how it works on the system, okay, and then let them do a couple of configuration of the quotes. You'll see that can be very easy to use. If you can do a Mia Samsung PBX configuration, it's a lot easier than this. Right, and this can eliminate your mistakes and give you that edge, the professionalism you need.
Okay. So you basically walk in as a very experienced sales guy, but you've got 2 days of knowledge.
100%. You walk it in.
Thank you. Yeah.
Second bull, I think you've invested 1.8 million in this.
Yeah.
This click to quote. It's taken 32 years. And we've taken the system and we've duplicated it. We want to make it as easy as possible for the salesperson to quote. So you need to go out to order some more Samsung. Right. Samsung cameras. So we'll make the system easy to replicate. And to help you win more business, ultimately, at the end of the day. Okay, guys? Anything else you want to add? Thank you.
Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed the session.
Thank you, guys.